How's it going, guys? I'm Aaron from PhoneDog.com. We have the Galaxy Tab 10.1, the Galaxy Tab 8.9, and now the Galaxy Tab 7.0+. So you need a new tablet to put your music on, or maybe you like browsing the web. The Samsung Galaxy Tab 7.0+ is finally here. Now, we saw this redesign around the Galaxy Tab line on the 10.1-inch model. Then we saw the 8.9-inch. Now we're seeing the 7.0 or 7.0+, and it's pretty well spec'd. So I'm just saying, you put your music on this. So if you're like me and you're a fan of Michael McDonald, well, you can get your music on. You can sing songs like, "Listen, baby, ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide enough, baby." You know, stuff like that. Or, you know, "What a Fool Believes." That was a shout out to you guys in the Phone Dog land, and for Mark and more for getting me to do that on video. So I'm just saying, you can put all that music on your Galaxy Tab, and as always, special thanks to our friends at Best Buy Mobile, because they don't hook us up with tablets, but what they do hook us up with is awesome phones for use in our One Paw Bandit game. So when you walk into Best Buy Mobile, you'll walk out working, whether it's a tablet or a phone or whatever it is, they'll help you set it up. Your email, your web, and more, so when you walk out that door, you're good to go. So here's a tablet, and you're seeing, you know, a dual-core 1.2 gigahertz processor on this bad boy. Obviously, 7-inch display over here. This is the Wi-Fi version, and it's a 16-gigabyte model as well. It has 1 gigabyte of RAM, and it's pretty well-spec, too. 345 grams, if you will, in terms of weight, and it's 9.9 millimeters thick, or 9.9 millimeters thin, depending on whether you're a glass half full or a glass half empty kind of person. It's got the camera here on the back, and it shoots video at 720p, and I believe it's a 3 megapixel camera on the back, if I remember right, and a 2 megapixel front facing, but don't quote me on that just yet. Android 3.2 over here, and you can see kind of a revised design around this with the back plate as well, and pull this off so we can get a better look at what it looks like here, and you can see, bam, there it goes. So it kind of fits right in with that design of the 10.1, or just seems a little bit more up to date, because you know you had the 10.1 and the 8.9, and then you kind of had an older design for the Galaxy Tab 7.0, the original one. So you can see overview and setup, see what's on, tap to watch, and some more instructions there. Now you get your health, safety, and warranty guide here. You get a Samsung Galaxy Tab instruction manual. You get some more stuff that you're probably never going to read, and then you get over here a US adapter. You get your AC adapter module here, which the US adapter plugs in and serves as a wall charger here with a USB cable input. It's got some headphones here with an inline mic. These are actually pretty nice headphones. We will we'll pull these out and take a look here. Let's see. It's late in the day, what can I say? Let me see if I can... That's actually a terrible excuse. I just haven't had enough caffeine today. There we go. Peel it off that way. And you can see here are our headphones. So pretty decent looking headphones to come with the package. And you know, nice in-ear mic, or nice in-ear earbuds there, with an inline volume or an inline microphone, if you will. So USB cable here, and then you got some extra earbud doohickeys, so you can make your ears extra cushiony and make them really comfortable in your ears. So quite a few accessories, in all honesty, for a tablet. Pretty impressed with that, and I'll go ahead and put those back in later. But let's power it up and see what it looks like here, and get a better idea of what's on the side. It looks like an infrared port there, but volume rocker, power button, 3.5 millimeter headphone jack on the top, and then you've got your micro SD card slot over here, charger, proprietary charging port right there, your speakers down there at the bottom as well, and obviously front-facing camera over here in the top right corner. So again, you know, it's a pocketable, I wouldn't say pocketable, but it's a device that you can fit in one hand, even though it's going to be kind of hard to use with one hand. You can get it to pretty comfortably rest in your hand. It looks good. And I like the back. It's a nice revision over the original. It looks less plasticky, even though it's still kind of made, you know, obviously made of plastic. The back gives it more of a premium feel, and it's nice to have a flash on the camera as well. So just to give you an idea, let me look here and see. I'm going to cheat for a second and look at the spec sheet, because I want to see what the battery is. 4,000 milliamp hour battery in this bad boy. And like I said, Android 3.2, so you can see it's running TouchWiz UX over it. And you do have the option to shift between all and my apps if you want to. And then you can see the apps that come pre-installed. And kind of in this TouchWiz form, you can see the 1 and 2. And then down here, you can see the typical TouchWiz UX enhancements. You got the clock down here, which clearly is not right. It is not 8:38 in the morning. It is 6:39 at night as I shoot this. And then you have a Wi-Fi notifications, GPS sound, auto rotation. You can turn the brightness up or down and you adjust your settings. And then you have Wi-Fi here where it tells you your connection. And then you have some information on your battery as well, and you can easily get out of that. So then you have some widgets here. Also, we can go back to the home screen and take a look, for example, at World Clock. And we can bring it up. Actually, I take that back. That's not a widget. That's a little what I like to call multitasking within a tablet, which Samsung's TouchWiz UX does a phenomenal job of this. And you can see, let's go over here, for example, and say, we're just at the blank screen. We're going to, you know, we're going to do something else. We're going to bring up the browser, for example. And actually, let's not bring up the browser. Let's bring up Gmail, just for example. And then we can say, oh, you know, I'm in the middle of doing, you know, Gmail stuff. I want to see the world clock. Well, I can bring it right up here and have it pop right up in kind of a multitasking manner, so I don't have to go all the way back out and come back in to the clock and then vice versa when I'm done. So I can easily bring up the calculator, do some quick equations. Sound like a really studious person. Do some quick equations. And you know, I can bring up task manager, things like that. All from this little part down here. So it's really nice. And of course you have your full keyboard and you have a TouchWiz style keyboard which you can use in portrait or in landscape mode. Although I think in this individual menu you can just use it in portrait. But you can see, pretty quick, pretty easy to type on. Even with a 7-inch display, it's reasonably large enough to type pretty quickly. Old Man McTweety, and I'm going to pull this away to do the password. And actually, I just realized I'm not connected at all, so that's not really going to help very much. But you got your basic stuff down here, which I'll bring back up so you can see. Back home, you can see which applications are open. Gmail, I can easily get back to that. And then, of course, here I have my screen capture button where I can easily, well, just like it sounds, capture the screen. So if there's a picture I want to show somebody or my screen, I can easily capture and bring that right over. You have shortcuts to Google to voice recognition or to connection problem because I'm not connected to Wi-Fi right now. But voice recognition, and then of course typical TouchWiz stuff that you've seen in the past. And actually, I'm going to go ahead and turn on Wi-Fi. We're going to get it connected to one of the networks here because I know it's going to pull it right up. And let's go into the network in my office, and we're going to put in the password. Phone dog 12345, and that's not the password. I'm sorry to burst your bubble, but that is that's not it. So we're gonna come back over here, and you can see we're back online, and then we can go back into Gmail if we want to, and continue along on our setup. And I'll put in that password. I feel like I'm pulling it away more than I'm actually showing it on the display, but that's okay. So there. And then we're signing in now. So it's a good looking device. You know, it's one of those ones, if you want a tablet but you don't need something as large as a 10.1-inch tablet, it's a pretty reasonable size and can easily fit in a briefcase or maybe a purse or a laptop bag, something like that. So it's a nice device. The improvements look good. It definitely gives it a more polished feel on the back, makes it look a little bit more premium than the older one did, which I thought kind of looked a little too plasticky at times. So in the box, in terms of applications, you get AllShare, you get Amazon Kindle, you get Google Books, ebook, you get Movie Phone, Google Music pre-installed. Music may not be pre-installed. That may be auto-downloading. I'll have to confirm that one. But anyway, Memo is part of TouchWiz. Next Issue, Pen Memo, Photo Editor, Social Hub, which is a Samsung thing, Media Hub, which is also Samsung Pulse, Samsung App, Screensaver, Videos, and more. So quite a few Samsung applications pre-installed on this device as a result of both TouchWiz UX and the fact that obviously this is a Samsung product, but still, not too bad in comparison to some of the devices we've seen in the past coming from some of the carriers, where there's quite a bit of carrier-installed bloatware. Most of the stuff I think you may find useful, and you know, especially if it's any indication, little widgets like this or little multitasking things like this, it's going to be something that you use. And you know, Samsung probably wouldn't have put it on unless they thought people were going to use it. Stuff like Media Hub, Social Hub, that stuff could come in handy at some point. Much more coverage to come on the Samsung Galaxy Tab Plus 7.0 on phonedog.com. Be sure to like us on Facebook, facebook.com/phonedog. We're always doing contests. We're on there quite a bit. We're a super cool group of people. And frankly, you should like us. So I'm just kidding. But like us for reals. Like us at phonedog, facebook.com/phonedog. Follow me on Twitter, phonedog_Aaron. Let me know what you think about this. If it's too big, too small, I'd like to hear from you. phonedog_Aaron. And on Facebook at facebook.com/phonedogab. Thanks so much for watching. As always, we'll see you next time.